Hello everyone. In the previous video, we discussed the distance formula and solved some questions in exercise 7.1. Now we are going to solve the remaining questions of exercise 7.1. For that, first consider the third question. Determine if the points 1, 5, 2, 3 and minus 2, minus 11 are collinear. Given three points here, we have to check whether they are collinear or not. Before that, first let's see what is meant by collinear points. Three points, suppose A, B and C, we are going to take three points. If they are said to be collinear, that is three points A, B and C. They are said to be collinear if they lie on the same line. See, the three points here lie on the same line. That means the points here A, B and C are collinear points. A, B and C are collinear points. If the three points do not lie on the same line, they are non-collinear points. For example, consider another point D, which is outside this line. So you can say the points A, B and D, A, B and D, we cannot draw a line passing through A, B and D. That means the points A, B and D are non-collinear. So now you have understood what you mean by collinear points. Three or more points are said to be collinear if they lie on the same line. Okay, so here we have to check whether the line segments joined by the three coordinates are collinear. So here we are going to solve it like this. Take the first point as A. So let A, which is 1, 5, and B, that is 2, 3, and C, minus 2, minus 11, be the given points. We will check. To check, AB plus BC is equal to AC. AB plus BC is equal to the full length AC. We have to check that. If this condition is satisfied, then we can say that the three given points are collinear. Okay. So for that, what is AB? AB means that is a distance between the points A and B. So we have to find AB, then BC, distance between B and C, that also we have to find. Then after that, AC, that is the distance between A and C. So three distances you have to find. So first, let me find AB. AB is equal to, using distance formula, x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Okay. So let's take the coordinates of A and B as, let x1 is equal to 1, y1 is equal to 5. Similarly, x2 is equal to 2 and y2 is equal to 3. Substituting the values here, you will get x2 minus x1, 2 minus 1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, 3 minus 5 the whole square. That's equal to square root of 2 minus 1, 1, 1 square, 1, plus 3 minus 5, minus 2, minus 2 square is 4. So that is equal to square root of 5. That is the distance between A and B. Now we find the distance between B and C. So BC is equal to, applying the distance formula, before that, we will take the coordinates x1 is equal to 2, x2 is equal to minus 2, then y1 is equal to 3 and y2 is equal to minus 11. And up by the distance formula, x2 minus x1 the whole square, minus 2 minus 2 the whole square plus minus 11 minus 3 the whole square. That is equal to square root of minus 2 minus 2 is minus 4. And minus 4 square 16 plus minus 11 minus 3 minus 14. And minus 14 square 196. 196 plus 16. Square root of 16 plus 196, square root of 212. That is equal to 2 under root 53. That's the distance between B and C. Similarly, you have to find AC. So AC is equal to square root of, applying the distance formula. So when we are considering A and C, we have to choose x1, y1 and x2, y2 according to that. So x1 is equal to 1, y1 is equal to 5. Similarly, x2 is equal to minus 2 and y2 is equal to minus 11. Now, x2 minus x1 the whole square, minus 2 minus 1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, minus 11 minus 5 the whole square. That is equal to square root of minus 2 minus 1 minus 3, minus 3 square 9 plus minus 11 minus 5 minus 16 and minus 16 square 256. So square root of 256 plus 9, that is 265. Now you look, you got AB as root 5, BC 2 root 53 and AC root of 265. So let's add AB plus BC. AB plus BC. Now how much is AB plus BC? Root 5 plus 2 root 53 and AC is equal to square root of 265. So from these two values we can say that AB plus BC is not equal to AC. When we add these two irrational numbers, you will not get this irrational number. So AB plus BC is not equal to AC. So we were checking this condition. So we got that AB plus BC is not equal to AC, which means that the given three points are not collinear. So the conclusion is, therefore, the given points are non-collinear. Non-collinear. Now let's solve question number 4. In question number 4, it is asked, check whether 5 minus 2, 6, 4 and 7 minus 2 are the vertices of an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle means a triangle in which two sides are equal. If two sides are equal in a triangle, we can say that it is an isosceles triangle. Here we have to check the given coordinates are the vertices of an isosceles triangle. For that, let's check where these points come. That is, when we draw the coordinates x and y, y dash, x dash and origin, the points, first point is 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 is somewhere here, 5 minus 2. Then 6, 4. 6, 4 is somewhere here. Then 7 minus 2. 7 minus 2 is again here. 6, 4. Okay. So if we join the points, we will get a triangle. This is only a rough figure. Joining the points, you will get a triangle. Let's mark the points as first coordinate. The first coordinate given is 5 minus 2, that is A. Then this is B and here it is C. For checking this is an isosceles triangle, we need just to show that any two sides are equal. For that, we need to find the distance between each points. Okay, that is AB, BC and AC. For that, the given points are A, which is 5 minus 2, then B, 6, 4, and C, 7 minus 2. First, let's take A and B. So AB is equal to distance between the points A and B. Distance formula, x2 minus square root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. When we consider the points A and B, we have to take x1, y1, x2 and y2 according to that. So here x1 is equal to 5, y1 is equal to minus 2, and x2 is equal to 6, and y2 is equal to 4. Applying these values in the formula, square root of x2 minus x1, 6 minus 5 whole square plus 4 minus minus 2 the whole square, that is square root of 6 minus 5, 1, 1 square is 1 itself, 1 plus 4 minus minus 2 is 4 plus 2, 4 plus 2 is 6, 6 square 36, square root of 1 plus 36 is square root of 37. So the distance between A and B is square root of 37 units. Similarly, you have to find the distance between B and C. So BC is equal to square root of, now choose the points x1, y1, x1 is equal to 6, y1 is equal to 4, x2 is equal to 7, y2 is equal to minus 2. Substituting the values, x2 minus x1, 7 minus 6 the whole square plus minus 2 minus 4 the whole square, which is equal to square root of 7 minus 6, 1. 1 square is 1 itself. 1 plus minus 2 minus 4 minus 6. Minus 6 square, 36. Square root of 37. So BC is also square root of 37 units. Now it's remaining to find AC. AC is equal to square root of, for that choose x1 is equal to 5, y1 is equal to minus 2, then x2 is equal to 7 and y2 is equal to minus 2. Substituting the values, 7 minus 5 the whole square plus minus 2 minus minus 2 the whole square. That is square root of 7 minus 5 is 2, 2 square 4 plus, this is minus 2 plus minus 2, that is 0. Square root of 4, which is 2 units. That is AC is equal to 2 units. So from the first two coordinates AB and BC, from the first two distance itself, we have found that the distance is same. So that is AB is equal to BC. That means two sides are equal in this triangle, which means that this is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, the given points are the vertices of an isosceles triangle. Next is sixth question. Name the type of quadrilateral formed, if any, by the following points and give reasons for your answer. Some coordinates are given. First, we have to check these coordinates form the vertices of any quadrilateral. And after that, we have to name which is that quadrilateral. You know, quadrilateral is, it's a plane figure with four sides. It can be square, rhombus, parallelogram, rectangle, etc. So here we have to check which type of quadrilateral is that. Before that, first we need to know whether they form quadrilateral. Okay. So first take the coordinates minus 1, minus 2, 1, 0, minus 1, 2 and minus 3, 0. Let's draw the coordinates and mark these points. Okay. So the coordinates are x-axis and y-axis with origin O. Let's mark the points 1, 2, 3 on positive side of x-axis, and here negative side, the values are marked, and similarly on y-axis we mark the points just for marking the points. First, minus 1, minus 2. Where will minus 1, minus 2 come? That is in the third quadrant. Here is minus 1, minus 2. Then 1, 0. 1, 0 is on x-axis. then minus 1, 2. So first point is A, second point is B. Then minus 1, 2, minus 1, 2 is in the second quadrant. Then minus 3, 0. Minus 3, 0 is in the on the x-axis. So A, B, C and D, we are giving the names. So by seeing the figure, we can say that the four points will form some quadrilateral. That is, they are not lying on a straight line. So here the points are lying in different parts. They are non-collinear. So a quadrilateral is formed. Next, we need to find the distance between that points only. If you join the points AD, BC, BC and AB, you will get a figure like this. ABCD is a quadrilateral. Now let's find the distance between each points. For the first question, let A be the point minus 1, minus 2, B be the point 1, 0, C be the point minus 1, 2 and D be the point minus 3, 0. Applying distance formula to find the distance. First you find the distance AB. AB is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. x1 value is minus 1, y1 value is minus 2 and x2 value is 1 and y2 value is 0. Substituting the values, x2 minus x1, 1 minus minus 1, 1 minus minus 1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, 0 minus minus 2 the whole square. That is square root of 1 minus minus 1, 2, 2 square, 4. 4 plus 0 minus minus 2 is plus 2, 2 square, 4. So that is equal to square root of 8 units. That is the distance between AB. Similarly, you can find the distance between BC. For finding the distance between BC, the points are 1, 0 and minus 1, 2. Let's write x1 is equal to 1, y1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to minus 1, y2 is equal to 2. Applying distance formula, x2 minus x1 minus 1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, 2 minus 0 the whole square. That is square root of minus 1 minus 1 minus 2. Minus 2 square is 4 plus 2 square 4, that is square root of 8 units. BC is also square root of 8 units. Similarly, you have to find all the sides. So BC is equal to square root of 8 units, and when you find CD will also, you will get as root 8. Then DA is also square root of 8 units. All these distance you have to find using the distance formula. Now look, AB, BC, CD and DA are same. All the values are equal. That means it can be a rhombus or square. Okay, now let's check the diagonals of this quadrilateral. The diagonals are, one diagonal is BD and another diagonal is AC. First let's check the diagonal AC. For the diagonal AC also, applying the distance formula, for that x1 is equal to AC, no? So x1 is equal to minus 1, y1 is equal to minus 2. Then x2 is equal to minus 1 and y2 is equal to 2. Applying the values, x2 minus x1 minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 minus minus 1 the whole square plus 2 minus minus 2 the whole square. That is square root of, this is minus 1 plus 1, that is 0. 0 square is again 0. Now 2 minus minus 2 is 2 plus 2, 4. 4 square, 16, that is equal to 4 units. Similarly, we will get the diagonal BD. BD is equal to 4 units. Applying the distance formula, you will get BD as 4 units, which means that all the sides are equal. Our conclusion is this: all the sides are equal. All the sides are equal and diagonals are also equal. a quadrilateral in which all sides are equal and the diagonals are also equal. That quadrilateral is a square. So the quadrilateral given in the first question is a square. Now for solving the second part, the coordinates are given -3, 5, 3, 1, 0, 3 and -1, -4. Same as we did in the first question, let's mark these points in our Cartesian plane. So drawing the Cartesian plane, see the points -3 to 5 are the, so just marking the points. The points are marked now, and first point is -3, 5. That's a point in the second quadrant. -3, 5. Let's take the point as A. Then 3, 1. That's the point in the first quadrant. B. Then 0, 3. 0, 3 is a point on y-axis. C. Then -1, -4. -1, -4 is in the third quadrant. Take the point as D. C, A, C and B. Here we have to understand that this A, C and B lies on the same line. That means those three points are collinear. If we join the points, you will get a figure like this only. You will not get a quadrilateral because this is a straight line. So we cannot form a quadrilateral using these points. So that's given in the question. Name the type of quadrilateral formed if any. If any is given, that means it is not sure that it should form a quadrilateral. So the second solution is this. We cannot form a quadrilateral with the given points. Similarly, you have to solve the third part of this question. Apply the same method as we did in the first part to solve the third part of this question. Now we are going to solve the question number 7. The question is, find the point on the x-axis which is equidistant from 2, -5 and -2, 9. There is a point on x-axis which is at equal distance from these two given points. Let's look how the points will be. X-axis, y-axis and origin. The first point is 2, -5. Just this is a rough figure. So 2, -5 will come somewhere here in the fourth quadrant. Then -2, 9 is in the second quadrant somewhere here. Okay, and we have to find the point on x-axis. The point is on x-axis. Suppose the point is formed here, we have to find the coordinates of that point. So if you join the points using a line segment, the first point is 2, -5. Take that point as P and the second coordinate -2, 9 as Q. And the point to be found, that is the point on x-axis, you have to take as A. Okay. Now, in the first video, we discussed that the coordinates of every point on x-axis, the coordinates of every point on x-axis is of the form x, 0. x, 0 is the coordinate of every point on x-axis. So this condition you have to apply there. Okay. So the solution will be like this. let A, that is x 0, be the required point, okay. Next we will check what is the given condition is, which is equidistant from both the points. That means this point is at equal distance from both the given points. That means this PA is equal to QA. So given PA is equal to QA. PA means there is a distance between P and A. So applying distance formula here. Again, QA means that is also the distance between Q and A. There also you have to apply the distance formula. Okay. So PA square root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. When you are taking P and A, take x1 as the coordinates of A, that is x1 is equal to x and y1 is equal to 0. Similarly, x2 is equal to, that is the coordinate of the point P, and P is, x2 is equal to 2 and y2 is equal to minus 5. Applying here, x2 minus x1, that is 2 minus x, or we can write x minus 2 the whole square plus minus 5 minus 0 the whole square is equal to square root of. Now distance between Q and A. Similarly, take x1 is equal to x, y1 is equal to 0. X2, that is the coordinate of the point Q, which is minus 2, 9. So minus 2 and y2 is equal to 9. Applying the formula, x minus minus 2, that is x plus 2 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, 9 minus 0 the whole square. Look here, in both sides square roots are there. For simplifying, we will square both sides. Squaring both sides, we will get like this, x minus 2 the whole square plus minus 5 minus 0, that is minus 5. Minus 5 square, 25. 25 is equal to x plus 2 the whole square plus 9 minus 0, 9. 9 square is 81. 81. Next step is we have to expand this x minus 2 the whole square using a minus b the whole square identity. A minus b the whole square identity, a square minus 2ab plus b square. So x square minus 4x plus 4 plus 25 is equal to x plus 2 the whole square. You have to expand using a plus b the whole square, which gives x square plus 4x plus 4 plus 81. Now you can cancel the like terms on both sides. See, there's an x square here. Here also one x square is there. Then 1 plus 4 is there. Here also 1 plus 4. Now bringing the remaining like terms to the one side and numbers to the right side. Minus 4x. Taking this plus 4x to the left side, it will become minus 4x is equal to, the number here is 81. And taking this plus 25 to the right side, it will become minus 25. Minus 4x, minus 4x, minus 8x, minus 8x is equal to 81 minus 25 is 56. So from here we can find x is equal to minus 56 by 8, which is minus, means the point A, that is the required point, the point A is minus 7, 0. Minus 7, 0 is the required point. That means this point represents minus 7, 0, and that is at equal distance from the points P and Q. Question number 10. Find a relation between x and y such that the point xy is equidistant from the points 3, 6 and minus 3, 4. The coordinates of two points are given, and given that it is at equal distance from, is at equal distance from two, from the given point xy. So let's mark 3, 6. 3, 6 is in the first quadrant, take it as P, and one more point is there, minus 3, 4, which is in the second quadrant somewhere here, that is Q. And xy is another point, the coordinate of another point, so we can take it anywhere. take that point A as xy, and if you join QA and PA, given that the distance between these two points are equal, that is A is at equal distance from Q and P. If so, there is a relation between these two points x and y. We have to find that relation. Okay, for that, so we have taken the point P as 3, 6 and Q as -3, 4, and also A is the point xy. Now applying the given condition, given that PA is equal to QA, PA and QA are equal. Now here itself we can square. Before applying the distance formula, we are going to square, squaring both sides. PA square is equal to QA square. Now what is PA square? For finding PA square, we can take x1 as the coordinates of P. x1 is equal to 3 and y1 is equal to 6. Similarly, x2 is the coordinate, x coordinate of the point A, that is x, and y2 is equal to y. So PA square means x2 minus x1, x minus 3 the whole square plus y minus 6 the whole square is equal to. Now QA square, distance between Q and A. So taking similarly x1 is equal to minus 3 and y1 is equal to 4, x2 is equal to x and y2 is equal to y. Applying in this equation, x minus minus 3 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, y minus 4 the whole square. Now expanding the identities, these are the identity form, either a plus b the whole square or a minus b the whole square. You have to expand it. x minus 3 the whole square is x square minus 6x plus 9. Then y minus 6 the whole square, y square minus 12y plus 36 is equal to x minus minus 3 is x plus 3 the whole square. X plus 3 the whole square is x square plus 6x plus 9 plus y minus 4 the whole square, y square minus 8y plus 16. We have expanded using the appropriate identities. Next step is cancelling the possible values or like terms on both sides. See, 1x square is here and right side also 1x square. Then plus 9 is there, so plus 9 also we can cancel. Then y square. Now the remaining terms, bring all the terms to the left side. So here whatever terms are here in the left side, minus 6x is there, and along with that, taking plus 6x to the left side, it will become minus 6x. Now then the number is minus 12y. Then in the right side, the y term is minus 8y. When it come to the left side, it will become plus 8y. Then 36 is there in the left side, so plus 36 minus 16 is equal to 0. Now simplifying, minus 6x minus 12x, then minus 12y plus 8y minus 4y, then plus 36 minus 16 is 20, plus 20 is equal to 0. Now if you observe these three terms, we can see that you can take 4 outside, 4 as common. So if you take 4 outside, you will get minus 3x minus y plus 5 is equal to 0, which means that minus 3x minus y plus y 5 is equal to 0. Now multiplying by minus 1 on both sides, you will get 3x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0. So this is the relation between x and y. X and y, the coordinates x and y satisfies this equation.